So guys, now we're going to focus in on one of the most important intermediates for all of organic chemistry, and that's called the enolates. Okay? So specifically in the base catalyzed tautomerization mechanism, right? The base catalyzed version, we form a resonance stabilized intermediate called an enolate. Okay, let me show you. Remember that in the base catalyzed version, what winds up happening is that my O negative grabs the alpha proton right away, right? So I wind up forming a double bond here and then kicking electrons up to the O, okay? This gives me a possible resonance structure though, where on the one hand, I have the negative charge on the O, but I could easily resonate that down to the carbon, right? Cool, and then it could resonate back up. Both of these are considered the enolate anion, and both of them are correct. But for the purposes of this section, one of these is gonna be far superior in helping us predict what a product will look like, okay? And the one that we're gonna use is the one where the negative charge rests on the carbon. Why? Because that's gonna help us to realize that alpha carbons in a basic solution are actually good nucleophiles. Okay? That's totally different from anything else we've done with carbonyls before. Because up until this point, guys, we've been taking carbonyls and we've been saying that they're good electrophiles. Okay? That it's good to add stuff here. Okay? But now what I'm telling you is that the alpha carbon is actually a good nucleophile. Meaning that the alpha carbon can actually do this. Crazy, right? So we have a whole new set of reactions, a whole new branch of carbonyl chemistry opens up to us when we use enolates, okay? So now what I want to do is I want to use the next section to compare nucleophilic addition, which is a mechanism you should already be familiar with what's with the mechanism of enolates.